Hey everybody, tonight's video is called Guilt into Restoration of Hope. And tonight we continue our pass-through study here in the book of Isaiah, where we're going to be looking at the Messiah's community, Guilt into Hope. And this chapter is going to be a quick video, in my opinion, because it's only 6 verses. So this is one of the shortest chapters in the book of Isaiah besides Isaiah 20, which also has 6 verses to it. So we're going to look at verse 1 to start out here. And it says, "And in that day, 7 women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own food and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by your name to take away our reproach. So in the day of the Lord, he will judge wicked women indirectly by allowing the slaughtering of males. Thereby, this would produce a shortage of men as available for husbands." And this is the result of the judgments that we left off in chapter 3 back on Saturday. "And 7 women would chase after one man, as many shall fall by the sword," in Isaiah 3:25. And when I read these verses, I remember the jokes of grandparents and all that, that, you know, when you were a little kid, they might have said something like, you know, "You're going to have to beat the girls off with sticks. You're going to have all the girls chasing after you," so on and so forth. Kind of reminds me of those silly days. But they would be so desperate for marriage that they would not expect their husbands to provide for them at all. They just wanted a man. You know, whether it was an actual man or someone that, you know, appears as a man. "And it would be enough to have a reproach taken away by taking the name of a husband, so that it wouldn't be looked down upon them as unmarried or childless, as it would have been in this time period." And today, it seems like today's society, we live in an opposite kind of world, where it's, you look down upon being married more often than not, and being, you know, with children, people see it as a burden, rather with someone, you know, has no children. And in verse 2, it says, "In that day the branch of the Lord shall be beautiful and glorious, and the fruit of the earth shall be excellent and appealing for those of Israel who have escaped." So the branch is a messianic title occurring a few times, like Jeremiah 23:5, Jeremiah 33:15, Zechariah chapter 3 verse 8, and Zechariah chapter 6 verse 12. And the thought behind the title, the branch, relates to 2 Samuel 23 verse 5 of that growth. And the life of the branch will bear spiritual fruit. And later on in Jeremiah 23:5 and Jeremiah 33:15, as mentioned, you see branch. In verse 3, it says, "And it shall come to pass that he who is left in Zion and remains in Jerusalem will be called holy, everyone who is recorded among the living in Jerusalem." So holy or set apart is another way of describing the remnant who will inherit God's prosperity in that day. And one major theme that we get through the book of Isaiah is on holiness. And remember that Zion represents Jerusalem. And recorded is speaking of their names written in the book of life, as seen, spoken about also in Exodus 32:33, in Psalm 69:28, in Daniel chapter 12, verse 1. In verse 4 through 6, to finish the chapter, it says, "When the Lord has washed away the filth of the daughters of Zion, and purged the blood of Jerusalem in her midst, by the spirit of judgment and by the spirit of burning, then the Lord will create above every dwelling place of Mount Zion, and above her assemblies, a cloud and smoke by day, and in the shining of a fire, flaming fire by night. For over all the glory there will be a covering, and there will be a tabernacle for shade in the daytime of from the heat, for a place of refuge and for a place of shelter from storm and rain. So, like I said, quick chapter tonight, only 6 verses. And we see the third picture of Zion resembling the first, an eventual purification and prosperity in the land. In the future, inhabitants of Jerusalem will enjoy the Lord's protective covering over the glory on Mount Zion. And this recalls Ezekiel's prophecy of the return of the Shekinah into the temple in Ezekiel 43, verse 2 through 5. And purging style of judgment would not be seen again until chapter 27. And burning, it signifies judgment throughout the book of Isaiah. So when we see burning, think of judgment. And a holy Zion would be produced by consuming the faithless and purifying the faithful, unlike the burning of the fire of judgment back in verse 4. And this cloud and fire signals God's protective presence in verse 5, just like it did at the Red Sea, however the pillars were in Exodus. I can't think of it at this second. But verse 5, just like the Red Sea in Exodus 13, 20 through 22, over the tabernacle in Exodus 40, verse 34 through 38, and in the wilderness of Numbers 9, 15 through 23. And in verse 5, his presence covers a restored and sanctified Mount Zion. And did you know that Jewish weddings include a canopy over the bride and bridegroom as part of the ceremony? And we'll go over to Exodus 13. So I want to make sure I say it right. All right, so I think I had the wrong reference written down right there. But the pillar by day and night is really what I'm trying to cover, where I lost my track of thought there. So we're going to wrap up right here. And we look tonight at the judgment on the daughters of Zion and a glorious hope. And we saw the desperate condition of the daughters of Zion. And ladies, on a side note, what you should learn from the daughters of Zion is never be too desperate for marriage, that never fall for someone unwisely to marry for the wrong reasons. And that is, you know, going to make a life of hardship and potentially divorce. And always seek a husband who will protect and provide for the household. Don't just settle for nothing. And in verse 2 of Isaiah 4, it showed us the glorious hope of the branch of the Lord. And I want to go over to John 15, verse 1 through 8. John 15, verse 1 through 8 says, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away, and every branch that bears fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. You are always clean because of the word which I have spoken to you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit on itself unless it abides in the vine, and neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me, and I are in him, bears much fruit, for without me you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered, and they gather them and throw them into the fire, and they are burned. If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it shall be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, so that you will be my disciples. So Jesus Christ is the fulfillment of the promise as he yields glorious spiritual fruit. And behind the title branch of the Lord is faithfulness in life. And Isaiah 4:3 showed us holiness marks the society where the branch of the Lord reigns. And note that holy doesn't mean super spiritual or sinless perfectionist, like we might think sometimes. It doesn't even mean spiritually superior or obnoxious, but it is generally separated to the Lord with all of your heart and your life and your mind and body. And it is a life lived apart from the thinking and heart of this world, the flesh and the devil, and you live apart for to the Lord. In Revelation 20, verse 12, Revelation 20 verse 12 says, "And I saw the dead, small and great, standing before God, and books were opened, and another book was opened, which is the book of life. And the dead were judged according to their works by the things which were written in the books." So the book of life is opened at the judgment throne of God. And we see that the chapter ended with more characteristics of a society where the branch of the Lord reigns. And if we are really born again, we ought to want to be washed and cleansed, have the presence of the Lord, and enjoy the protection of the Lord. And many, I find, only want the presence of the Lord and protection constantly, but that doesn't occur apart from the Lord's cleansing. And that's going to wrap up today's video. We'll see you next as we look at the vineyard of the Lord, Isaiah chapter 5, and I'll let you know when that will be. So have a great rest of your evening. God bless. We'll see you next time.